In this lesson, we will discuss the difference between absolute pressure and gauge pressure. When the pressure of a fluid is measured with a device, it must be measured relative to the pressure somewhere else. If we measure the pressure of a fluid relative to the pressure in a vacuum, which is zero, we are measuring the absolute pressure. The absolute pressure, denoted by P abs, is more often used in thermodynamics calculations. If we measure the pressure relative to the ambient pressure, which is usually the local atmospheric pressure, we are measuring the gauge pressure, denoted by P gauge. Since we live in a pressurized environment, in practice it is usually much easier and cheaper to construct pressure measuring devices that measure the gauge pressure compared to measuring the absolute pressure. The gauge pressure is frequently used in fluid dynamics calculations for convenience, because often the force caused by the ambient pressure cancels in all directions and can be neglected. The equation relating absolute pressure and gauge pressure is P gauge equals P absolute minus P ambient. For most car tires, the recommended gauge pressure is between 28 and 36 psi. You can purchase an inexpensive pressure gauge at any auto parts store which measures the gauge pressure. So let's say a pressure gauge reads 32 psi, and you are able to determine the local atmospheric pressure is approximately 14.7 psi absolute. Rearranging the formula and plugging in 32 psi for P gauge and 14.7 for P ambient, the absolute pressure in the tire is 46.7 psi. When writing a pressure down, it is important to specify whether you are using absolute pressure or gauge pressure. In the British gravitational unit system, sometimes the letter A is added to the end of psi to indicate an absolute pressure, and sometimes the letter G is added to the end of psi to indicate a gauge pressure. However, gauge pressure is used so frequently in fluid mechanics that many people will leave off the G and simply report gauge pressure in PSI.